Hello, welcome to join us at the Hannover Messe 2019. This is Xinhua News reporter Zhang Yu. Hannover Messe started in 1947, started from an undamaged factory after the World War II in Germany. And it has become the world leading industry exhibition now. And nowadays it has 6,500 exhibitors attending the exhibition. And amazingly, there are 1,300 Chinese exhibitors attending the exhibition. And the chairman of the Messe said that Chinese is now taking a leading role and a major role in leading the industry future. And today we're going to show you some of the Chinese ones and the Western ones. We can get a small glimpse of what is happening at the front of the industry. And the first one, we are at the exhibition of a Chinese corporation called Haier, and they are famous for producing fridge and washing machines, and they are now trying to import the Industry 4.0 concept to make their new products. And what you are seeing now is DIY assembly line, a mini assembly line. And let us see. Let me make a refrigerator for you, maybe here. And we can see we can select the cabinet color, white, blue, pinks, and my male, so I choose blue. And select the door color, I choose the white one, with the drawer color, maybe white, yeah. And the next one, it's highly customized. And they need me a signature. My name here, Yuan. I photograph. You can see that my face is definitely recognized here. Here, I want to take the photo. Okay. Yeah, perfect. Oh, quite a nice one. Yeah, then I produce it. Packing urgent. Yeah, it's urgent. Successful operation. So you can see I think the Haier is trying to tell us the future industry will be changed. Not like the model, they produce things and we buy things. And it's like highly customized, highly automation, and they produce the things you want. We can see about the small assembly line, and there are lots of robotic arms, and they recognize the cabinet, and they recognize the front panel color, and they can recognize everything, and it's highly automated. And no people involved. And let's go and see whether my product is being processed. You can see the robotic arm select the doors, the white one. Yeah, maybe this one. Yeah, the blue drawer. Haier is featuring its Cosmo platform. They collect data from the users to perfect their production. It means it's not the old models that they produce things and they sell things, then it's end of the process. And they are trying to imitate a future industry that they produce things and you use things and they the customers use the things and they collect the data and collect their habits and their features and make perfection of the production. So next time if you buy a refrigerator or washer or some other kind of products, they will use your data to make your DIY product, and they can offer updates, fresh updates about your software. You can see the washers are being made here by the robotic arms. Minutes ago, I tailored my washer, a small refrigerator. Yeah, you can see. Products are being delivered to me.
Yeah. Okay, here's the products.
Yeah. It's mine?
Yes, you ordered.
Yeah,
it's
fine.
Yeah, here is yours. Yeah. Your signature and your phone.
My orders are placed 5 minutes ago and yeah, now it's produced. You can see my pictures, nice one, and my signature. So this is a model. I have to say to our audience that Hannover Messe is nowadays a very big exhibition. It will take many days to cover all the halls. And right now I'm in the hall 6 and to show some of the exhibitions. I'm sure that I will not show all because it's too big. It takes maybe 1 hour to go to 3 halls. And now we can see we are near the Huawei exhibition. Huawei is an advanced company in China selling their network service and the solutions for the communications. And let's see what they get here. We can see the Huawei exhibition is separate to some parts. Our connected factory, connected car, and other things, and 5G technology. And now we are joined by Mr. Wu to tell us about the...
Is it live?
Yeah, is it live?
Okay.
It's
okay.
Live.
Hello.
Yeah. Say hi to our audience.
Hey, hi. My name is Helen and from Huawei. So next, and I think I can give you a very short tour about the Huawei booth. So okay, so first what you can see here is we call it
only the highlights. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. So it's a connected factory.
Yep.
So actually, you can see it's a very simple scenario of the factory. The robots and the AGV automatic guidance vehicle. So actually, you can see the robots will send the signals and the message to the AGV, and you can move. And
the robots send the signals, not the people, right?
Yeah, the robots. But actually, how to build this message with the wellness network? Huawei provide the ELG unlicensed network to cover the robots, the AGV, and also the warehouse, the product line. So we make this network, we build this network to cover all the factory, to make all things connected to the network so that they can communicate with each other.
Uh-huh. So the machines connected with
machine to machine. So actually we can, in the future we can realize the unmanned factory. Mm-hmm. There's no people here. And all the machines work each other automatically.
Yeah.
So based on the Huawei ELC network. Uh-huh. Yeah. So we think in the future and more factories will choose this solution to help them to improve the efficiency for this collaboration. Yeah.
Have they put into use this
technology? Of course. Firstly, we put this solution in Shanghai, in China. In Shanghai, Yangshan Hub is the biggest hub in the world. And every day here are so many containers move from the ships and to the AGV, and we provide this ELT online network to cover all the hub to make it all the AGVs. And maybe in the future, if all the audience have the opportunity, you can go to the Shanghai to see this, to visit this harbor. Yeah, you can see no people here, there, and all the AGV moves and controlled automatically. Yeah, it's very, very amazing. Okay. So, and the next, I want to introduce to all the people here, is about the 5G.
Well, we can see a small robotic arms placing aboard.
It's very interesting. It's a very interesting demo. You can see here is the moving robots, and here's a little ball. And we just make sure the ball at the middle of the plates all the time. And why can we realize very precise control of the robots? Because of the 5G. You can see the 5G access point
because
here.
Because it's a round ball, so it can move easily.
Yeah.
So maybe I'll try if I push
Yeah,
it.
Of course. And you can just, yeah. And then it will adjust the position of the rub of the ball and then make the ball at the middle of the plates. So, you know, to realize this very precise control of the robots, the latency is necessary. The latency, you can understand the latency just like your reaction speed.
Yeah.
And the 5G we can realize the latency lowered to 1 millisecond. So you know the 4G maybe several maybe 40 or 20 milliseconds. So for this control, for this precise control, the 5G is necessary. So in the future, we can put this technology, we can put the 5G to more and more robots, to more and more project line, to help them to realize the more and more precise control of the robots.
Yeah. So our audience should understand that 5G is not about the mobile phone internet speed. It can use in the industry. Let us do it again.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
And the next. So here you can see this is a DF7 crossback from the PIC. And
it's a new model, right?
It's a new one. It's the first launched in Europe today. And actually, of course, Huawei, we do not produce the car, but actually this is the first one, PSA, cooperative with Huawei, we provide the ocean connected platform. We call it the IoT platform for them to realize all the car connects the network. So for example, when the audience, when you buy this car back to your home and you drive the car for 1 year, 2 years, and actually you can record all the historical data of the car. For example, you can see.
Where can I get the historical data?
Actually, you can use your smartphone. Yeah, smartphone or the middle screen of the car. So actually, so you can open the door and you can see navigation and yeah, you can see. So you can just choose different icons, of course, here. I'll put this. So actually, this is the basic function of the, you can see the navigation, okay? And you can choose so many extra functions of this vehicles, okay? So you can see this is the weather information and the distribution of the oil station, and also, which button I touch? Okay, sorry. So, try it again. So this is the weather and also the oil gas station and also the parking lots and also the traffic jam situation and also some accident, you can alert alarm here. And also with your smartphone and for example, it's your own private phone and you can just open an app and it's the My DS. Okay, so you can show some basic information of your vehicles, the energy consumption and also how many kilometers you drive for this weekend and also some historical data. But here's just a demo, here's no data because it's a new car, it's a new phone, okay. But you can just to check, to find, maybe last week, Tuesday, and you drive the car from the Berlin to Munich, okay, and you can get the speed, the power consumption, and also all the data of the vehicles. And also include the maintenance solution, information. For example, the gears, and also the wheels, and also the engine.
We can check if it is in perfect condition or not, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So actually, it's just like the connection between your vehicle to the smartphone. And also in the future, it's not the end. In the future, you can realize the vehicle to vehicle, and also vehicle to your smart home facilities.
Yeah.
And also maybe the vehicle to the right lights, the signal lights. to optimize the traffic jam.
Yeah.
So it's a big picture in the future.
Yeah.
And Huawei, we mainly provide the connections and also the platform. We call it IOV, Internet of Vehicles. For the
Internet of Vehicles.
Yeah, Internet of Vehicles. Yeah, also you can call it a connected car.
It's part of the concept with the Internet of Things, right?
Yeah, Internet of Things is a big concept, but you can realize Internet of Vehicles, Internet of the bicycles, you know, in China, OFO and MoBack is also the IoT, Internet of Things. Yeah, okay.
Well, amazing.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for your introduction.
Goodbye.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. And we will try to get around to find and maybe a Western corporation. Here we are at a multinational design platform, Autodesk. And we'll show you. They're building their own C-3PO. You can see that we know that building a robot is not difficult, but I think building a humanoid robot is not that easy. The Autodesk design is trying to make a humanoid humanoid robot with muscles, with the strings, and with the with the bones. I think it tells that the robot can, each arm can lift 5 kilograms of weight.
We're using an agile system structure and have sprint lengths for about 2 to 3 weeks. So every 2 to 3 weeks, we have significant changes in the hardware. And we use a framework that's called TAF Agile Framework that allows us to do this in an efficient way. And what we also do is we use Autodesk Generative Design because it fits very well with this agile development. Because, for example, for this hip, the whole development time, it's only 5 days. So because we don't model the shapes anymore, we just basically define the constraints. So we have a constraint that says, in this direction, we have a force of about 200 newtons. From the top, I have 2 kilonewtons. I have a bending moment on the hip of 140 newton meters. If we have a clear position to look at to negotiate with a robot, or generally a human normally, how we are passing on things. And for an industrial robot, passing this cart like this, it's exactly the same as doing it in a natural way. But for this robot, it's not. So basically what it automatically does, just because of how it's built, it makes human robotics interaction not only safe, but also natural and intuitive, and with that fast. It also has a dialogue system, so you can talk to the robot and use it with the demo chat.
Yeah, very interesting display of the robots. Actually, Hannover Messe this year, all the experts are focused on some of the issues, maybe future manufacturing, future robotics, and future artificial intelligence. And it is considered the future element of the industry. And I don't know whether after you watching this video, you are amazed or afraid, will there be no humans in the factory? Will there be more humans? More humans in the factory. It is undecided yet. So every exhibitor is trying to show their vision of the future industry. So, today's time is up, and I think I will show you around some other time maybe. And we have visited Huawei and IR and the auto design, and maybe the audience have got a glimpse of the future of the industry. And if you are so interested in the future industry, and if you like our videos, please subscribe our YouTube and Facebook and Twitter channels. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching. Thank you.